Job always had a saying that you have to go through your bitter middle to enjoy the fruits of success. And in some ways, it felt like that, okay, it's a heart attack, but this is just another bitter middle.
Ian Ozan, the host of The Ozone on ESPN 1420, saying one of the things that was on my mind after Coach's heart attack, the coach was strong, and this was just a bitter middle. I'm Andrew Clay. He's Seth Lewis. We're doing sports a little bit differently tonight as we remember head baseball coach Tony Robichaux, a man that won more than 1,100 baseball games, but impacted so many people. And we saw some of those men and women today come out at Russo Park to his memorial site.
Yeah, it's ironic, Andrew. He was a baseball coach as a profession, but we've barely talked about that. He was a man's man and a pillar when others felt weak. You know, his robisms weren't just clever phrases. They were life lessons to take with you every day. You know, one of my favorites, I think this came from this year, was the blinder on the mule, which is about pretty much focusing on what you can handle instead of looking at the entire field or task, because the mule can get distracted if it doesn't have a blinder on to be able to eat the grass. So for you, what is one of your favorite robisms?
Yeah, I really like the one where Coach talked a little bit last year at the end of the baseball season after they lost to Texas,
Texas State.
Yeah, when he talked about how you're not judged by wins and losses and by how fast you run the bases and what your batting average is, but you judge by who you are as a man and a father. And that's always been one I really like. We've talked a lot about, and we've shown a lot of the robisms throughout the day. Here's actually one we didn't get to earlier today that we both enjoy.
It's like a melting point, right? As I try to tell the team all the time, you put some chocolate candy bar on your dashboard, there's a melting point, you know? I mean, it's going to melt pretty quick, but you can put a clay pot in an oven and it can take 200, 300, 400, 500, you know, Fahrenheit temperature, and it hardens. So you got to decide what you're going to be. I mean, you're going to be, you know, a clay pot, or you're going to be a chocolate candy bar.
Well, that quote applicable as so many grieve today. Louisiana Athletic Director Brian Maggard released this statement today that read in part, "I will forever be grateful for how he prioritized development of his student athletes as outstanding young men first and baseball players second. Our community will forever benefit from his teaching, philosophies, and leadership."
Austin Robichaux, coach's son, tweeting tonight, "Honestly, it feels like a bad dream that I'm about to wake up from. I sure am gonna miss you, Dad." LSU baseball releasing a statement from Paul Maneri on Twitter saying, quote, "Tony was an outstanding coach, but he was an even greater molder of young men, and the positive impact he made upon his players is immeasurable." Longtime Louisiana softball coach Yvette Girard tweeting in part, quote, "He was special, proud to call him my friend and confidant. He lived his life trying to make the world a better place."
As much as we have talked about Coach and remembering who he is as a person, as you mentioned, we haven't talked a lot about the baseball. And Seth, he was one heck of a baseball coach.
He was.
More than 1,100 wins. Russo Park is that shade tree that he has talked about and been quoted. One of his robisms about building the shade tree that he may never get to experience. Well, that's Russo Park, and that's his legacy.
Absolutely. 10 conference titles, along with that 2000 trip to the College World Series, the 58-win team in 2014, which included so many talented players like his son, pitcher Austin Robichaux, and shortstop Blake Trahan, who we heard from earlier in the show, who's in AAA for the Reds. Listening to Robe talk about pitching, though, you know, he taught me a lot about baseball, and his pitching technique was so unique. He talked about the 15-pitch inning and trying to avoid that, and the three-run inning, and how teams that typically the three-run inning is something he preaches just about every
preach,
week.
Preach, man, that is a preach.
And so just those different things allowed me to watch baseball completely different, and like, all right, if they get more than three innings, if the other team gets more than three runs in an inning, I know that that's probably not going to bowl well for them in the final result.
Yeah, the coaching community is so supportive of him. Here's quickly what ULM head coach Michael Federico told KNOE in Monroe.
His teams play hard. They've got a little bit of grit about themselves, and you know, they're just who he is. They take on his image and what he believes in, and he just does an outstanding job.
Well, as we've talked about, one of the things that did stick with me throughout my time knowing Roe was what he did say at the end of last year about not being judged, and I think that's something that I hope everyone takes home tonight. You're not judged by how you do at work or your wins or losses or running to first base. It is who you are as a person, and that is something I will certainly not overlook.
Having got one heck of a coach.
Well, for Seth Lewis, I'm Andrew Clay, and we'll be right back after the break.